Hello, my fellow aesthetes, and welcome to my channel, Aesthete in the City. This is a nod to my closet cleanup video. I had you guys sort out your closet and make a keep, fix, and give pile. This is what to do with your gift pile. Instead of running over to the local Goodwill and just dumping all of your stuff and having everything sort of end up in a landfill, next best thing is to sell it or trade it. This is a great way to ensure that your stuff goes to happy homes.
I'm focusing on online selling just because we all have different thrift shops around us, so it wouldn't be accurate for me to post about something that isn't accessible to the majority. And honestly, thrift shops are pickier than selling secondhand online. They only want certain brands or garments, and they want something in season. I remember calling up a Buffalo Exchange near me when I was moving and asked them what they were buying, and they said men's jeans and women's jackets, and I had mostly dresses and crop tops. So needless to say, they didn't want any of the stuff that I had. They do this so that they don't get a ton of items they can't sell. That's why 80% of items dropped off at Goodwill end up in landfills, because they accept everything. Even things they can't sell. I'm also doing a follow-up video with tips on how to sell online, so after you pick your platform of choice, please consider liking and subscribing to see more. That video will include how to take product photos, what to expect from buyers, and selling on social media.
Alright, so let's jump into the profiles. Number one, Poshmark. I've had the most success on this site, but also it's because I had the most experience on this site. I used Poshmark to sell my clothes before my big move across the country, and I was able to make about $3,000 within the first month or two. I was particularly motivated just because if I couldn't sell these items, I would have to just give them away because I couldn't afford to take them. And it wasn't a seamless experience. I hit a bunch of roadblocks, but I read a lot of tips and reviews on the site to help me navigate through everything, and I would still highly recommend this platform. For all sales under $15, Poshmark takes a flat commission of $2.95. You keep the rest. For sales 15 or more, you keep 80% of your sales, and Poshmark keeps 20%. Payout is pretty seamless. You get paid out through PayPal, Apple Pay, Android Pay, and any major credit cards, or even a direct deposit to your bank. And this is one of the few sites that lets you use Venmo. Shipping, it's usually about a flat rate of $7.11, and the buyer pays for it. They probably have the most perks of the other competitors. They have bundle discounts, automatic authentication for any item over $500. Instead of going directly to the consumer, they get shipped off to their office for an automatic authentication to make sure the item is real before it makes their last stop to the buyer. And Posh Protect, sales are covered. Let's say you sell a top for about $10, Poshmark will charge the buyer $10 and hold on to the money for 3 days. The buyer will have those 3 days to accept or reject the item, and once they accept it, you get your 80%. Next is the showroom and the parties. They often hold theme parties for certain brands, like a Free People party or a dresses party, and you get to share your listed items to that party to kind of give it more life and make it more visible. And in that sense, more people start to add you and start to like and share your items. And instead of just like getting the one push whenever you initially post the listing, you get opportunities to make several. And this one's probably my favorite, the offer button. Not many people have this, and I'm not a great negotiator when it comes to this stuff, so I love having the offer button. What happens is if someone wants to make an offer on your top for $20, when you have it listed for 30, they can just send the offer. You have 24 hours to accept or reject or counter offer. And it's kind of like a not awkward way to like reject someone. I like to also include a certain photo, I'll post it up here, that kind of gives like what I'm willing to accept. Like I probably wouldn't accept an offer of 50%. Some tips and tricks for that. And of course, selling on social media. This website connects to all of your social media, so you can share photos of your clothes with your friends and see if anyone wants to buy them. Cons. Trades are not covered because Poshmark can't take a cut, so they don't want anything to do with it. And obviously, like, the buyer will have to like pay for shipping, and it's really expensive, so there's other sites that's better used for that. And be prepared to haggle on your items. People love to haggle. All right, next is The RealReal. They accept only luxury items. Everything is on a case-by-case basis. You send all your stuff in, they'll accept or reject each item. And even then, not all designers are accepted. For example, last time I went, they were not taking any DKNY because they had trouble selling those items. They informed me that the list changes, so if you are curious about a certain brand, check the website before scheduling an appointment. You will need to get your items approved, so there's a chance that you won't even be able to sell on this site. But when it comes to luxury items, I've had a great experience with them and trust them with my higher ticket items. Because they're dealing with such high ticket stuff, they do have the biggest cut, but it might be worth having the added security that they provide. If your sales are under $1,500, you guys split 50-50. If it's over, you move up to the next tier, which is your cut is 60. And if you're selling over 10K, you're bougie and you get 70%. You can set up a direct deposit once you've been given your items to consign. You get paid about once a month, so it's not a quick process if you're looking to get quick cash. One thing I like about the site is once they do have it in their possession, no more work from you. They're in charge of taking the photos, of listing the item, of promoting it, but it kind of sucks because you also don't get to dictate the price. You don't pay for shipping. You send all your items to them and they handle the shipping for you. If you cancel your item, you can request it back by mail if it's been too long and you want your item back. So let's move on to the pros. So they're great for luxury. When you look at your sales page, you get a breakdown of what your item is priced at, what percentage you get off each item, and when you get that amount. The cons, not a fast payout. You only get the earnings once a month and you don't get to dictate the price. I remember looking back at certain items that were seasonal or even vintage, and I remember thinking I would have gotten a lot more if I sold it myself, but it is what it is. But regardless, they had a great score on Trustpilot, 4.4 out of 5. Still better than Poshmark. All right, next is Mercari. This company is based out of Japan. They're dubbed as the online flea market, so don't expect to see any real designer on this app. The website cut is 10%. This is great because whether you're selling something for 50 cents or $50, it's still only 10% in commission in comparison to something like Poshmark, where you can end up owing money if your price is too low. And there's a $2,000 cap, so that's probably why you won't see a lot of luxury items, which is good in a sense. If you're selling internationally, there's always more problems in selling higher ticket items, so no matter what site you buyer does not rate you within 3 days, items are automatically rated with 5 stars and you're paid. They use PayPal, Apple Pay, Android Pay, and any major credit cards and debit cards. Mercari lets you choose shipping, whether you pay for the item as the seller or you make the buyer pay. Your items are probably self-fetcher if you offer to pay as a seller, but also I find that I do a lot of more local listings when I use Mercari, so sometimes I'll just meet up with them, drop it off at their office or their doorman or something. All right, next is Depop. They accept mostly men's and women's, no kids. They're more of a niche, very Gen Z crowd. Most of the buyers are under 26. Think like e-girl vibe. Sounds so old saying that. A lot of popular brands on the site are like Reformation, Off-White, Supreme, so that's kind of the vibe that's going on there. The website cut is about 10%. Payout is through PayPal, so it's instant, you don't have to wait. And shipping ranges from $4 to $17, buyer pays. They do have some unique perks like an explore page, bumping, which is essentially just moving your listing up and getting more visibility. And it's an international site, so people can buy your stuff internationally. I try to discourage it and just do locally just because the shipping just gets so crazy that sometimes it's not even worth it. Cons, and because it is international, you could find yourself dealing with a shop across the world that will price gouge you for shipping while you wait almost a month to receive your item. You can adjust your settings to only sell or even buy closer to home though, so that's nice. Beware of scammers, rude buyers, and lowballers. There are around and they're on every site, but when I went to the Trustpilot page, these were the main complaints. But they did get a pretty decent score, 3.9 out of 5. Next is Letgo. This is like Craigslist, but faster. No middleman, similar to Mercari. Focusing on local sales. You can sell anything on Letgo, from clothes to cars to furniture, you name it. Similar to most apps, you take pictures, write a description, set a price. People will message you about the item's availability, condition, and probably to negotiate it down. Once you select a buyer, you schedule a meeting and you can ask them to bring cash or Venmo you or PayPal you. There's no actual money exchanged on the site. So pros, you get all the money. They get no cut because you deal with everything. Cons, you get a lot of trolls. People will message you to troll on your page and mock you about the price if they think it's too high with no real intention of buying. And there's a safety issue. I feel weird about letting strangers into my home. Luckily, I live in an apartment building with security in a nice lobby, so I just try to meet them in the lobby. If you plan to sell a lot, make sure to take certain precautions like buying a money pen, one of those like money markers to make sure the bills are legit, and meeting in a public location or have someone with you. Next is Bunz. This is an interesting site. This is for trading only. It's based out of Canada. There's no exchange of money at all. And how that works, let's say, is you want to sell a top that you think is worth about 10 bucks. You would assign a trading value with their digital points, digital money called bits. So whatever the equivalent of $10 to 10 bits is, it's like 10,000, something like that. So you assign a value to your trade item. They can offer to trade with you. And if you don't like anything that they have, they can sort of buy your item with their bits points that they've accumulated from other trades. I thought this was a really cool concept. Now, I heard rumors about Bunz trying to turn their bits into a cryptocurrency, but I heard it failed and they reverted back to the point system. So there was a point in time where if you lived in Toronto, there were actual establishments that were also accepting the bits. So if you had leftover bits, you could go and buy like a coffee or something at a coffee shop. I don't know if that's still a thing that they can do, but I don't think anybody in LA accepts it. But either way, you can store it in your wallet and use it for other trades that you, I guess, want to buy from other people's shops. And the great thing about this is it does focus on local items, so you don't really have to worry about shipping. You can often just meet a person and trade up, similar to Letgo. So next is ThredUp. This is sort of my last resort site of things that, you know, aren't selling on Poshmark or Mercari or really anything. What they do is they send you this large bag and you fill it with all your clothes and you send it over to them. They go through each item and either accept or reject, and you can have your rejected item sent back to you, in which you'll have to pay the shipping, or you can opt to have them donate that to a charity. Now, if you're curious about how much you're gonna get, it's not gonna be much. I sent about, 20 items in a huge bag, and I got about $16 out of it. And I've heard some people getting as little as like $2, you know? So you really have no idea how much you're gonna get. If you're interested, you can go to the website and look up how much. They do give examples about like, oh, if you're looking to sell a Forever 21 dress, this is how much we're usually buying it for. And it's usually like a couple cents. It's not a ton at all. Like I said, it's sort of a last resort for sellers, you know, if you've got things that you just can't seem to sell. The payout also takes a little while. It takes about 1 to 3 weeks to process your bag. And best case scenario, you get about 20 bucks like I did. I got $16. But, you know, like I also said, you can get as little as $2. Shipping is free. You really only pay whenever you ask to send your clothes back if they do get rejected. And it's no additional fee if they get rejected and you opt to send it to charity. This website is, you know, like I said, last resort. It's a little effort, but it's also a little money. Trustpilot score is about 2.5 out of 5. Not one single excellent or good rating. That's kind of harsh. But it's more for the buyer, less for the seller, I think. Next is Trezy. This is kind of like Poshmark and The RealReal had a baby. They have The RealReal inventory, which is like designer only, but the selling experience is more like Poshmark. You keep your items and you get to take your own photos, but you don't have to pay for shipping, and they help Photoshop your photos by removing the background to have a little bit more uniform look on the website. And you get to dictate the price like Poshmark. Now, they will recommend a price, but I suggest looking at other websites to see what your item is going for. Any item over $50, they get 19.8, and that's not including the 2.9 transfer fee whenever you are transferring your funds to the PayPal, debit, or checking account. Some of the perks are they do let you have a ridiculous amount of photos. You get to have 13 photos, which is way more than any site does, and there is no character limit on your descriptions. So make sure you account for any discrepancies like stains, snags, etc. You don't want to have your items returned for little things like that. Usually what happens is when I document a stain or a snag, I circle it in the photo and let people know that it's there. And you know, if you want to like give me an offer, I'm more than willing to negotiate, but I would rather do that than have the item sent back. Cons: releasing funds. You can wait anywhere from 4 days to 21 days, depending on how your sale went. Next is eBay. I've never sold on eBay because you just hear endless stories about the scammers, but they are the most saturated website, being one of the oldest on this list. Now, I have heard of success stories, so I'm sure it's just something you'll have to learn by doing. I'm sure you develop a sixth sense for the red flags on the buyer's and seller's side, so like any of these sites, it'll be a trial and error experience. It's probably why I don't mind selling on the RealReal and for them to have such a big cut, because I just don't have to worry about anything like this. But if you have more of an entrepreneurial spirit and you want more of that cut, this is the site for you. It's very hands-on. You'll have a say in everything, and you'll get tools like a sales calculator. You can schedule posts so that they appear at the best times. And probably the most appealing to me is the timed listings that create a sense of urgency in each sales. You also get to see sales analytics so you can see how many people have looked at your item and how many people have bid on them. If I were to go down this route, I would probably share my listings on social media as well, just because people really have to look for your items for them to be found. It's not as easy as, they don't have parties like Poshmark, and they could sort of end up getting lost in the millions of other listings on the site. So make sure to get the right keywords on your items in your pop-up search. That's probably why you often see crazy long product names like women's t-shirt, long dress, maxi, split, evening, party casual, shirt dress, summer beach. It's an actual listing that I found. Add all the words in. It's cool. They're used to it. Just as long as it gets seen, that's what you want. So unfortunately, Swap isn't taking any new seller packages until August. It looks like their site is moving, but it looks like an interesting site that's gotten some decent traction in press. The process is similar to the RealReal, where you send in your items and they will accept or reject on a case-by-case basis. They do have a list of brands that they are looking, so make sure to check it out before you send things over. Now, they do have a pretty high cut in comparison to the other sites. If your item is under $8, they get 85%, and if it's over $8, they get 30%. Plus, there's a credit payout fee, and there's an additional fee for items in that category, that higher category of $8 and up. But they do have something that I haven't seen in other sites, and that is a sure sell guarantee, which ensures you'll make money on your items. If at any time your items have not sold, Swap will just buy them from you, depending on the category and the condition of the listed items. But on that note, the con is that you don't get to dictate the price. It kind of works the same way as the RealReal, where after they receive the items, they treat it like theirs, they handle the price, the photos, and the sale. And they do work a little bit slower and can take anywhere from 30 to 60 days for your items to be processed and listed. So this is not a quick cash option. And next is something that I've been seeing more and more on lists to on how to sell your clothes online, and that's Instagram. Now, I want to make the distinction of being a normal person selling their clothes and a retailer using something like, I think maybe it's like Shopify or something. If you go onto a retailer's Instagram, sometimes you'll click on a photo and you'll see a price pop up on several items, and then you can click on it and it goes to their website. That's not what it's gonna look like whenever you sell your clothes. It's literally just gonna be another Instagram. And for those of you that's thinking, oh, I have a huge following, I'll just use that. Even though that you do, most people that do sell their clothes on Instagram do recommend that you create a separate profile just for your clothes, just because people don't really like to get bombarded with sales. What you probably do is share your closet post with your personal IG and just share that as a story. I would probably use Instagram to sort of supplement something like eBay or even Poshmark or Mercari, just to let people know like, hey, I'm out here and I'm selling if you're buying. But I don't know if I'd use this as like a first go. And on that note, Facebook Marketplace is also sort of in that same category. The process is very similar to selling on IG, with the exception that Facebook will give categories to classify your items, and they will show you your items to local sales, so you don't have to share and share and share, like people can find it. Similarly to IG, you can easily share to your friends, but hopefully someone will just stumble upon it in your local explore page. Like I said, if I was selling on eBay, I would definitely double my list item on Facebook and IG. So these options are great for entrepreneurs out there. And you literally just post a photo of the clothes and people just message you like, hey, is it available? And you say yes or no, it's kind of like Letgo. Even though IG and Facebook are some great options, I think they're more there to supplement some of the other sites that are just solely focused on selling secondhand clothes. All right, so that's all I have for you guys today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please consider selling or trading your clothes instead of dropping them off at Goodwill so they don't just end up in landfills. So far, I've had the best experience with Poshmark and The RealReal when it came down to selling. So let me know if you guys had success in selling on these other platforms and what your favorite platform was. Please consider liking and subscribing, and thanks for watching. Bye. Okay, let's start it over. All right, next are the six. What the hell's wrong with me? Excuse me.